Captain on the bridge.
All right, captains, we are back here on the bridge. And today, yes, we got a lot of things to go over from the Star Trek Online X feed, the X Star Trek Online wiki, and the Stow Reddit. So, on screen. Yes, captains, before we get into this video, do us a huge favor and hit that like button to help this video, but also the overall channel out. But also, if you're new here, welcome. Consider subscribing here to the YouTube Bridge, where we're always on the lookout for like-minded captains to share our love, passion for Star Trek Online, but also things Star Trek. Now, that said, here we go. As we mentioned in the intro there, caps, a lot of things to go over, so we're going to do that. Drop the two ECs in that and give our conclusion. So, first up, so Star Trek Online will have maintenance on all platforms. So, this is already done as the drop of this video. So, let's head over here. And some we already know this was coming, but this was the patch notes for October 17. So, check out all the exciting changes coming to Star Trek Online in our latest patch notes. So, the 2024 Halloween event, we knew this was coming. So, that is now started. And we get the Beowulf's Blade and the Grudge Cat from Discovery. So again, we went over that in a previous video. We can drop that in the description below or the end card. But this blog, as with all of our videos when we're covering the news, will be in the description below for you captains to go over. And of course, the Witching Hour. So quick hot EC drop here, caps. The Patrol for the Halloween event is the best and fastest way to do it. Why? Because you're by yourself. You don't have to go to a pug or pickup group. All you have to do is that one singular patrol and you're done. Less than 5 minutes, done easy. You'll get three possible sort of outcomes when you pick that patrol, but they're all easy. They're all easy. So I highly recommend, especially if you're on a time crunch, less than 5 minutes, you'll be done that patrol and you get your daily progress. We know that because we did that in our stream earlier where we actually did our daily for the Halloween event. So that is for both PC and of course console, that is our recommendation. Gamma recruitment event, we know that's starting as well. So there's that. And of course we went over in our previous video as well, the Lamar Science Class Dreadnought has dropped as well. Now, there are some known issues apparently here. So the Beowulf's Blade cannot be upgraded once you reach level 60, PC only. The Beowulf Blade may be missing sound effects. That's console only. Well, there you go. The T6 Lamar UI, the icon of the ship in the change active ship menu, is missing. This is all platforms. The Infinity Courier spawned by the Lamar's Infinity Courier ability is invincible. But of course, this is only on console. It's all over the place right now. Lamar's electromagnetic echo pulse generator, the console cannot be reclaimed in the Dilithium store. So again, some issues here that they're gonna hopefully be rectifying right away, since especially the T6 Lamar, the ones that come, of course, that just came into Star Trek Online, since being a new ship, a promo ship, that should be fixed as soon as possible, in my opinion. So there's that. Again, with the patch notes, we'll have this in the description below, but we also just did our video yesterday going over that. We can link that also in the description below, my caps. So there is that. Next up, the Lobi Crystal Consortium is announcing a 20% sale in the Lobi store on all platforms for a week. Not the best sale, probably about the lower end sale. I think they've had 50%, so still pretty decent, especially with us captains who finish our event campaign or are sitting on a lot of Lobi. Definitely can use it here. And we have some videos. We definitely have some recommendations for either ground items or spaceships, which again, we'll actually probably link that in the description below for our recommendations for Lobi items. If you're waiting for sale, here you go, 20% on Lobi on all platforms. So from October 14th to the 21st. That seems, why, the 14th already? Did we not cover this already? Well, it's the 21st, I guess maybe the weekend. I guess I must have missed the low buy store sale there, my caps, or I thought we did and we covered it, but whatever. It's on now as of this video, and it goes up until the 21st. So still some time as the drop of this video. My apologies, caps, but the 20% is now on, especially on PC, PlayStation, and Xbox. So there you go. Now, these next couple of vlogs, I will shout out to my fellow cap, Dwayne. Thank you, Dwayne, for posting this on the Discord. And this is what we meant in the intro when we have to go over stuff from the Star Trek Online wiki, because this was the link he dropped in the Discord. So, the portal to the captain's table via the Enigma Nebula has also received a new makeover. Out of nowhere. Only in the Sol system, though, as the portal near Kronos is the original and shown here for comparison. So, this is what it looked like before. Kind of ugly. It's kind of an eyesore, to be honest with you. And now, this is how it looks like. Now, this reminds me of the portal that shoots out from the console on the Shrike. Shout out to you, Mike, for gifting us the Shrike there. But this is what it reminded me of. This is much better. And what we're going to do actually at this point of this video is go on to the Stourbridge, because why? Well, we want to kind of show that off. There it is. It looks pretty cool, not gonna lie. I much like this compared to the old one. So, same location from where it was. When you enter into the Sol system, you just kind of go to the left there and you can't miss it. You see it there, and it does look 100 times better. And thought we would show that off here at Cap so you can see it there on the Stow Bridge. So there is that. Turn that off. Go back here to the Stow, so the Star Trek Online wiki. So again, this just happened, I believe, a couple days ago. This is October 16th. I never even noticed it, to be honest with you. So old, new. Definitely loving the new. So there is that. Again, shout out to you, my cap, Dwayne, for not only this one, but also this. You link this in the Discord as well. Live now on Tribble Test Server. Apparently has a few new changes coming out tomorrow. Of course, the Halloween update. Firstly, Admiral Quinn's new makeover. So he's been given a new costume head sculpt, it seems, before and after included. So that's the old, I believe. And then, no, that's the old. I believe now that's the new. So let's go over the pictures here. There he is sitting in his table. But yeah, I believe this is the new one here. So actually, you know what we'll do? We'll actually go back to the Stourbridge and show this. Why not? Close that again. Open that up. Say goodbye to the portal. Quickly zip to Admiral Quinn's office, and we'll show how he looks now. Because we did look at it earlier there in the stream. But here it is. This is how it looks. This is how he looks. No. This is how he looks now. Take that off there. Get as close as possible to his face. But yeah, that is how he looks. And much better. Definitely looks more, I guess, realistic a bit. I guess, especially when you compare it to the old one. So again, we'll go out of that, go back to the X. Have a look there. So that was his old one. Here's the new one. That was his old face. Here is his new face. So welcomed. Didn't really think he needed a facelift, but they decided to give him a facelift. So again, huge shout out to you, Dwayne. Thank you for sharing that on the Discord. We'll make sure that we link this also in the description below for you caps to go over when you want. So there's the two there. Now, I saw these two posts when I was actually at work earlier on the Stowe Reddit, but also Dwayne did also link this. But we'll go over here to the Stowe Reddit here. So info on the Horizon Class Remaster, because now there is a Horizon Class Remaster. This was posted by Endeavor Gaming. Shout out to you, sir. So as you can see, now we have this being remastered. So we have a before and after the Horizon Class Research Science Vessel. There, I mean, did it need one? No, but if we look at it, it is a TMP-ish looking skin. Now this already has a TMP skin, but they decided to give it more of a TMP skin again. My apologies. I was thinking of the Oberth. My apologies, no. So now they have this push now for, I guess, some of the ships, and I think it's due to Thomas, because he does love the TMP arrow. And yeah, we have this for you caps who are liking this ship. Well, there you go. You have now a TMP skin if you would like to use it. At least that's what it's looking to me. Caps, you let me know what it looks like to you, but that definitely looks like a TMP warp nacelle to me when I look at that. So a bunch of before and after pics. So we'll zoom in on that a little bit here. So as you can see, the before, which actually this more looks like a bug for some reason is what I'm looking at, or from what it reminds me of. Actually, it looks like fly eyes. No, is it just me? I'm sorry. I don't know why all of a sudden it reminded me of fly eyes, but it did. Fly's eyes, sure. So as before, there's the after, kind of the aft three-quarter view, and now you have the front there once again. So there's that picture, and then you have also this one. It gives a side-by-side comparison of the before and after. When you look at it there, okay, I'm seeing a fly. Caps, let me know in the description below if you're seeing a fly. I am seeing a fly right there. No? Okay, just me? Okay, gotcha. So there's that remaster. And it was done by, so Thomas has posted some before and afters of the New Horizon by Pundus, which was designed by Scorpion. So shout out to Pundus, Scorpion. There you go. For those caps who love the Horizon, you get a new skin. So there is that as well. Now, the other thing and last thing that we wanted to go over here in this video was this, posted by Commander SFC3. Thomas Marone on Twitter breaks down the visuals of the Lamar class Voyager A in Star Trek Online. So we go here. So this was by Thomas. So also out today is the Lamar class Voyager A Science Dreadnought. It is always an honor to bring a new hero ship to life in Star Trek Online. The ship was modeled by Tobias Richter and brought into Stowe by Pundus. So huge shout out to Pundus again. It also has some cool support craft. So in the blog that we went over yesterday's video, we did not have a picture of that. So we do now. So we'll have a look at this first. A couple more angles of the Lamar class. Again, as I mentioned in the video, it's a mix kit bashing of parts for me. The nacelles, the Sovereign, the Saucer Intrepid, the secondary hull Deflector, kind of reminds me of the Vesta. It's a hero ship, so it is on our list, and we'll kind of get to that in a future video. But right now, I had mentioned in that video that we will eventually get this. It is on the list, so when we do, we'll of course share it here on the channel. But again, we have a surprise for you, and a huge shout out to a cap there that will do a video on that separately. But yes, the Lamar class has better looks here. It is a bigger version of the Intrepid Order. It's upsized because now this actually has and can kit bash with the Sovereign parts. For those who have the Sovereign, well, there you go. You're going to be able to kit bash it with the Sovereign parts. So there's that. So again, Tobias modeled the Infinity Experimental Courier, which you can use in an ability attached to the Lamar. At Pundus did the intake on this ship as cool, or on this cool ship as well. So this is how the Infinity Courier looks like. And it kind of looks not that bad. Now, this actually reminds me of a ship that a good friend of ours, Nick and me and Stu, was flying in Star Citizen, if I'm not mistaken. Is it just me? I don't know. It just kind of reminds me of that, but it does look pretty cool. It reminds me of the Peregrine fighters, sort of, especially the engines there. Or actually, this could remind you of the DeLorean too from Back to the Future. But anyways, I'm going all over the place here. First Bug Eyes, now DeLorean. But it's a cool looking thing. The Infinity here, the Courier. But at least now we get a better picture of what that looks like. And of course here, let's not forget its hangar pets, the Mark II Nova Flyers. These guys were modeled, of course, by Pundus again. So we have a look at this. Sure, if that's what it looks like, I have not watched Prodigy. So if this is what they showed, then great. Again, it's always great to see stuff that has been on screen put here to Star Trek Online. So huge shout out to the devs for doing so, and the work that they do, of course, is amazing. And if this is canon, well, there you go. The Mark II Nova Flyer, modeled by Keen Sin, material by Tobias Richter and Keen Sin, designed by Ben Heban. So there's that. Finally, here are some orthos of all three ships prepared by Pundus. Like I said, it is very exciting to now have the stars of Star Trek Prodigy Season 2 in Star Trek Online. So he's not wrong there. So another shot here of the Infinity Courier, top side and the front. Not a bad looking ship. Of course, the Lamar itself can top, front, and the side profile. So this is where I get the look of the Vesta right here. That's where it reminds me of the Vesta's secondary hull. So the deflector is kind of too square. I wish they kind of would round that off a little bit more as opposed to make it more square. But again, I'm just nitpicking at this point. And again, another shot of the Mark II Nova Flyer, the top, the side, and the front. So there you go, my caps. Thought we would also go over this because, well, this just, of course, dropped in Star Trek Online. So we wanted to just kind of go over it again because we have better shots of it, of the Lamar class. So, caps, let me know in the description below what you think of the Lamar class, either by looks or by how it's going to perform. I'm curious how you caps feel about this ship. I'm a little 50-50. Said that before, say it again. It is still on the list because it is a hero ship and we do want to add it to the fleet regardless. So, but with that said, that is the video, my caps, the update video. Do us a huge favor and hit that like button. Subscribe here to the YouTube channel. And of course, we will leave it on this note until the next vid.
Live long and prosper.